Hey, boy! I just got a big package in from a fan from upstate. And she sent, she'll hope you work for these people because this is expensive stuff here. And she sent me a letter. I'll read that in a minute. But it's knife, fork, and spoon, olive oil, and balsamic vinegar dispensers right there. You see down there, boy? See, we'll zoom in on them a bit. And this is, I don't know if I can say it right, Calavita brand, extra virgin olive oil. And some of their balsamic vinegar of Modena. Oh, that's the good stuff, I know. And it matches my clock up there on the wall. You know, the dispensers do with the fork, knife, spoon. See these here, boy. So I had got that on them bottles. That's real nice. And she sent me some dish towels. Man, thanks. Man, that was awesome. She wrote me a little letter here, or a note, thank you. Hey, JB, just a little something to show my appreciation for your work, for the work you do on your videos. I came across this and thought it would go good with the wall clock that Miss JB gave you. Keep those videos coming. In this handwritten card, like that there. Thanks, girl. I appreciate that, Miss Linda. That was real nice. And I want to send you something, too. Send some non-perishable Cajun food items. And that'd be a nice exchange. Thank you. I'm going to do a Greek kafta or kafta or whatever you call it that you normally made like a shish kebab, but I'm going to go ahead and make them into burgers. And they're real good like that. You can eat them on pita bread or regular burger bread or whatever you want. You can freeze them. They make good meatballs too. First I got to make my that garlic feta salad dressing. And we're going to take a little different twist on it this time. We're going to put a little bit of kosher salt in there with the oregano. I can figure out how to open this on, bitch. No, you can't. Come on for that. About a half a teaspoon. And here's that mint. This mint is fresh, and it's real strong. You don't use too much. See, I got a little pinch like that. That's strong stuff right there. I bought this at an international grocery store. Come in a big bag that I got in the freezer. Last time, I didn't have any extra light olive oil. But this is extra light, and you can use this in the food processor. Now you know, huh? Let's get some feta. Make sure it's good. Yep, it's good. We'll put it in there. 2 heaping teaspoons. Like that there. Now here's something to tame the heat down on the garlic. This is just some buttermilk ranch dressing mix. You put this in there. And that's going to tame that heat down a little bit. I ain't got no lemons this time. We just splash it with some, here's our EVOO. The light now. Got some salad vinegar. I think I used this last time. We'll put that in there too. And we got to have some cracked black pepper. Even though about 1/8 a teaspoon. See in there? Since I ruined that other food processor, we're going to use this. I usually thin it out more by adding some water to this. You have a thinner mixture. Imagine that. I wonder how wine would go in there. May go okay. Now if you're gonna taste it, be careful you don't stick your finger in there on the blade, because the blades in these things is sharp, boy. I went ahead and run it for another 30 seconds to get out the garlic all pureed up. And it's not as hot like this by adding that ranch dressing. It tames the heat down on the garlic somewhat, so you're not really fuming as bad. And those who said that Miss JB make you go sleep in another on the couch, she can carry her ass on the couch herself. Once I'm sleeping, ain't nobody waking me up and getting me out of the damn bed. I'll tell you that right now. Backhanded across the head. Or I'll pull a knot on top of your head. There you go. Big enough for you to tow a boat down the road with. Hook up a trailer to it and gone. Put that knot on your head. So, we'll go ahead and transfer this to another container and put it in the refrigerator. Because it's got to sit up in the fridge for a little while to let them flavors come together real good. You paying attention, boy? I hope so. Let's continue with this dish. Let's go ahead and put a little bit of paprika right there. Some mint. And this mint strong, strong. I told y'all that. Some oregano. Use fresh if you want to. I got it fresh outside. Oh, you son of a bitch. Come out of there, oregano. We need some allspice for this. This is for the kafta. Kafta. Whatever you want to call it. That's too much. That's strong stuff. We got to get some of that out of there. Yeah. Only need about a pinch or two of that. Very strong stuff. We need some cumin. About like that. And I grind this stuff fresh. And I put it in these little pins, these jars. Because I got them. We need some kosher salt. About like that there. We need some pepper. Look, white or black pepper, huh? We gotta get some garlic in there and some grated onion, and that's like the flavor explosion that goes along with this, along with parsley. So let me get did with that. We also I'm gonna go ahead and put some garlic powder in this rather than fresh garlic, just for the hell of it. I'm running low on garlic. We'll save it for something else. Let's go ahead and cut us up an onion and grate it into my singing bowl. I'm going to peel the skin off this onion. And I'm going to try not to peel the skin off my knuckles while I'm grating this bad boy. Just be careful. See that? Grate him up. And you're going to start crying while you're doing this. Just get ready for it. Don't breathe. Hold your breath for about an hour. As long as you don't get it in your nose, yeah, cry, because it's your sinuses that's making you cry. just hold your breath or go underwater. Stick your head underwater, right out the submarine. God damn, that shit hit me. Stick your head underwater, out the nuclear submarine, and then you won't get it in your eyes like I just did. No sunglasses ain't gonna help. It gets in your sinuses is what it does. So grate a whole onion, a medium onion. What it makes you cry, when? And drink pop, dude, that way you don't give a shit. Let me get done with that. Now that all the crying's over with, go ahead and put your bunch of parsley in there. And that was about a half a bunch of Italian flat leaf. And look, I still got all my knuckle skin and I ain't bleeding nowhere. Well, this is green blood like that right there. That's parsley, boy. So we're gonna wrench this off and then whack it up fine. If you got curly parsley, use that. You can even use cilantro in this. It don't matter. Parsley. Something green. Give it some color. So let's go on and wrench this off. I didn't wrench it before, but I'm wrenching it now. I got my little salad centrifuge out here. And green centrifuge. Somebody wrote in, it's kind of like playing with a top that you grew up with. Said this one don't sink. You know how they went, made all the funny noises. So it's draining all the water off of that parsley. Now we can chop it up. And look, I took all the stems out of it. You don't want to use them stems. Remove them. Chunk them in the trash or make a tea. Make you some tea with that. Look at Chinese people would do. Put some garlic in there and some, boy, that'd be good. Some lemon and some garlic and them stems with some onion and stock, beef stock, fish head stock, ain't going there. Sorry. Alright, so we got that parsley all dried out. We'll go ahead and put it on a professional grade cutting board. Come out of there. All y'all come out of that. Good enough. And I got one of these little handy dandy, look like a mini strip pizza cutter. And we just gonna grind them up. On that professional grade cutting board. We don't even have to wash it when we dump. We just chunk it in the trash. You paying attention, boy? I hope so. I don't want to have to repeat this. And you better be recording, you stupid camera. Yeah, him is. Obviously. Come on out of there. Put that in there in your crying eyes. Put all your seasonings in there. Now, stuff for the landfill. How about that? I got some 80-20 grind chuck right here. And we're going to put that in there too. And it smells good. Nothing like the There's always room for all God's creatures. Here on the earth, right there by the mashed potatoes, the gravy, and the grind meat. I wonder if the cows cried when they got grinded up. Who gives a shit? Mix all this in, and about the only thing we're gonna do is Cajunize it just a bit. And I have some Cajun seasoning right here. And if they don't send me none free, I ain't gonna mention their name. I don't care no more. Really don't. Here we go. You can make shish kebabs out of this, sir. Put them on skewers and all this bullshit. We're just gonna make burgers. You can also make meatballs out of this. And that'd be real good too. Just so you gotta mix this all up. Let me get done with this, alright? Alright, here boy. Now let's make us some burgers with that meat. Got my hands all washed again. Only thing you need to know about this is it's gonna be yum. I'm just gonna make some burgers. And you can freeze what you're not gonna cook. This freezes well with all this seasoning in it. And Miss JB was gonna come show y'all how to make what the hell was that, pita bread. I got news for you. It takes 3 hours to make pita bread from scratch. So we just allowed to have this on hamburger buns. I'm good with that. Now, a little bit left over, we'll freeze that. I'm sure I can eat 3 of them right there, right now. Well, after they cooked, boy. Come on. Girl, dog, cat. We're gonna go ahead and put these in the fridge and just let them firm up a bit so we can handle them. And I can slap you in the head with that if you was over here. God damn, I got no clean hands. Shut the camera off. Come here, paper towel. Now you get to shut off with this. Now Miss JB claimed that she was gonna come help me with this meal, but I don't see her ass in here. So here's like the fourth paper plate I think I done dirtied up. More for the landfill. And you know, one of the highest points around Baton Rouge is the landfill where they made a little mountain. It's a high point. And I helped contribute. How about that? Chunk it all in there, boy. So for this laughing rice pilaf, you can get your onion. And we gotta slice it up. I need to sharpen that knife. It kind of dull. Let me do that. Sharp as a razor. Cut your arm off now. I don't think we're gonna use this whole onion in that rice pilaf. Use half of it and save some for the salad. Get the flim-flam skin off. It's the easy way to do it. Get all the trash out of here. Come on, trash, go on out of there. You're going in the landfill too. We're gonna whack this up and put it in that pot. Oh, where's my EVO02? I ain't gonna use the light. Let's get the good stuff. Onion whack up. Some more extra virgin olive oil. Nope. Yeah, extra virgin. That's what it says. Is you is or is you ain't a virgin. Onions. Kosher salt, flavor them onions like that there. some white, black salt. No, it ain't black salt. You know, they really do have that. That was, pepper. Let's go on and chuck some, whatever the hell you want in there. Some oregano. Come on out of there, boy. I ain't got all damn day. Let's go get this sauteed down a bit. Then we're going to add some garlic to it. Meanwhile, we're going to take some beef bouillon. Four of them for that amount of whatever the hell it is. Come on in there. Four cup, four cubes. Chunk them in there. You get that silver, that shiny stuff off of them. Alright. Now I done peeled all them little red skins off of that. Did you know that I made these little cubes?
Yeah.
So four cups. Let's dump some water in there. Nuke it and get them worried, melted. Look here, I just made some beer. No, I didn't. Had some onions going in there. Not onions, garlic. And this for the rice pilaf. And this is only two cups or two and a half. You gotta add some more water to that. Now, four cups of water, two cups of converted rice, parboiled rice is going in here. Let's get this up to the barrel first. Oh, burn it down a little, boy. What's wrong with you? Get that to burling, and we're going to add two cups of rice in there. You still recording, boy? You about non-union. You know that? I said shut off, not start. May have missed that step. I dumped some shit in there, all right? So we're going to do this best we can. As JV says, you got to go get a massage. So, go on, get your massage. Yeah, I got some frozen peas and carrots. I chunked them in there. And this for the rice pilaf. Down there, boy. Pay attention. Alright, for the rice pilaf, we're going to put in with four cups of stock, water, and all that shit. We're going to put in two cups of parboiled rice. I don't care what brand you need. As soon as that comes up to the boil, we're going to cover it. And, come out of there, cover. Give it a stir. And reduce it to simmer, low as it'll go, for 20 minutes. See, it's up to boil again. Give it a stir around. And then black pieces in there is that, don't worry about it. Just eat it. The dry seasonings. Reduce the simmer for 20 minutes. What? Are you paying attention?
No, I ain't. You're still recording, boy.
So I just busted apart some regular iceberg lettuce, and we're gonna rinse it really well, wash it, and get it ready to eat, and put it in this nuclear centrifuge to rinse him off. just bust it apart. If you want romaine, get you some romaine. I ain't got that. I got this. Oh, shut up, timer. And in the centrifuge it goes. Let's go ahead and grill up these Kafta burgers. Yum. Now our grill's at 600 degrees. We're going to go ahead and wire brush him down a little bit. But if anything living on there, it don't too much matter at this point. You can eat it. It ain't going to kill you. 600 degrees means that dog's hot. It's going to put us a couple chunks of wood on there. Like that, that's hickory. Got a grill grate back on that. And we got some burgers. I ain't going to make them all. I'm going to make some of them. Let's chunk them on there. Like that there. They've been resting in the fridge. Yeah, you know, boy. He was paying attention. It's these burgers. We're going to go put them in the oven on warm. Because I'm going to eat two or three and Miss JV can have the rest. Veggie washed veggies. Alright. Knife. Slice them up. Now I can't eat the seeds out of this tomato, but I can eat the flesh. So we're going to do that. Sacrificial. Like. Yum, right there. Let's see what we're going to do with that. No pita. It's all right. Use a hamburger bun. Veggie tables. Right on there. No seeds in the veggie tables. Yum, boy. Now, let's go ahead and build us a Sammy. And a salad. Onions, bell peppers, maters. Just bust them up and throw them on there. A little bit of black pepper. I'm glad that was black pepper and not salt. And here's that sauce that I made. That Grecian garlic sauce. Dump you some of that on there. Yum, boy. Oh, we gotta have some olives. Oh, we gotta have some feta cheese on there. Just like that. Ain't nothing better than goat cheese. Bah! Bah! Hummus. Gotta have it. Yum. They got all kind of flavors of hummus you can get. I'm gonna go ahead and put you some olive oil on there. I like that. And a little sprinkling of paprika. And some calamari olives. I like that. Yum, boy. Now let's get us some rice pilaf. Yum. Oh, you know what? Well, we gotta have a little EVOO on that too. Put you a little sprinkle on that. More sprinkle. This stuff good for you. That's just fruit on that. Well, Chad, what else you gotta have, JB? Kafta! Rock and roll, my friend. Mo Kafta. Yum. Yum, yum, yum. I don't never watch no cooking shows since Julia Child died. Juice Stand and, man, it was my favorites. I never ever watch the new shit that they got on the TV. Never. That's so stupid. I mean, just, how many ingredients I gotta go buy? Gotta go buy the whole spice section at the damn grocery store. And then come home and make some. Fail. No. I'll do it. If I ain't got it in my cabinet or in my refrigerator, that ain't gonna happen. That's just dumbass stuff. You can make it taste good without 5,000 different ingredients and all this kind of shit and all this prep work and all this crap. You don't need all that, man. That's the Cajun way, I'm sorry.